a.m. at St. Emily's. Thursdays, 7 a.m. at St. Joseph.
P.M. at St. Anthony.
If you did not get a change to fill out one of the forms for our church directory, please pick one up in the back of the church. Please join us for the seminarian breakfast with the Knights of Columbus following Mass. Today we pray for the people of the Holy Spirit Catholic community.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Today we celebrate the Epiphany of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord manifests himself, although small, but with all his majesty. Let's participate in this celebration with joy. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the light of all nations. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you govern with justice and peace. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you protect the poor and save the afflicted. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory.
Let's pray. O God, who in this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of the star, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds covers the people. But upon you, the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of the nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you, dromedaries from Midia and Ephah. All the Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense and proclaiming the praises of the Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. that the Gentiles and co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Jesus Christ through the gospel, the word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising, and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler, my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out, and behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord. Merry Christmas, everyone. We are still in the Christmas season. We have all of today, and then tomorrow with the Feast of the Baptism of the Lord. That is the official ending of Christmas. That is when the season of ordinary time, the numbered weeks of the year, begin. So right now we are still in Christmas. If you still have your Christmas tree up, you have done well. If your Christmas tree is a real Christmas tree and is dried out and is a fire hazard, no shame in taking it down. And it's very interesting. We began the Christmas season in the manger, and today at the Feast of Epiphany, we are right back at the heart of Christmas in the manger.
this time where we meet the three kings who have been journeying around the church and have finally come in front of the altar, the three wise men or magi from the east. The importance of the Magi and their significance for us is revealed in our first reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. The nations shall walk by your light. The Magi are a symbol of foreign-born people, the nations, actually all of us, now gathering with Israel in worship of the Father through the coming of the Messiah, because of the coming of the Messiah. The Gentiles are brought into relationship with the Father through the Son, who is called Christ and Lord. Now all peoples are invited into covenant relationship with the only God, exposing the universal character of the good news, the universal character of the gospel. The arrival of these Gentiles represents a fulfillment of a prophetic yearning for a time when God will gather all his people, Jew and Gentile, so that the whole world will proclaim the praises of the Lord together. Think of our psalm today. What did we sing? Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Or, as the letter to the Ephesians declares, that was our middle reading, our second reading today. It has now been revealed that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise of Jesus Christ. The Magi, who only appear in Matthew, also serve another purpose. They help establish the identity of the baby Jesus. They help us to see who he is. The Magi travel from afar to find the newborn king of the Jews in order to do him homage, we heard in our gospel reading. The word for homage in Greek in this gospel is proskuneo, which can mean and does mean prostrating. It's where we get our word prostrate from, and worshiping. Those for whom you prostrated yourself, literally laid down in front of them or knelt down in front of them or bowed down in front of them, those are people that deserve your worship. So, in other words, the first gift that all the Magi, all three of them offer, is worship, is reverence. In this worship, Matthew uses the Magi to help us know who Jesus is. The Magi are establishing a high Christology, a high understanding of the nature of Jesus as Christ. The three gifts also reveal the identity of Jesus. The Magi help us to know through the gold, through the frankincense, and who Jesus is and who he will be. And you might be pleased to know that if you like to explain to your children that the Magi's gifts symbolize his kingship with gold, his priestliness with the incense, and his martyrdom with the myrrh, you might be pleased to know that Saint Jerome, in the 4th century, in the 300s, likewise made this same association to the gift. So it goes way, way back. Interestingly, understanding the gift of myrrh, a myrrh is a balm that you put on the body of someone who has died to keep their body fresh for burial. Understanding the gift of myrrh as an anticipation of Christ's death was already found as early as in the writings of Irenaeus and Origen, both of whom died in the 2nd century. Given the message of the universality of Christ's church, symbolized by the foreign-born Magi, and the reference to Christ's death in the gift of myrrh, we can already see a certain Eucharistic or paschal character present in Matthew's infancy narrative. What does that mean? It means that already in his birth, we see a foreshadowing of his death, and we realize that to be born in Christ for all of us means that we will participate also in his suffering and his death to spread the message all around the world. The Magi symbolize the Catholic nature, the universality of Christianity, meaning that the gospel is for the whole world. And this gospel today also teaches us of the divinity of Jesus, especially through the worship of the Magi. And it is a challenge in our Eucharistic worship, calling us to greater communion with our brothers and sisters who seem different than us. The Magi likely came from Iran, and here they were coming to Israel to worship the Christ. They were called into communion with Christ. When we say amen to the offer of Christ's body and blood, does that incorporation into Christ cause us to rejoice in our unity with those who grew up with a different language or a different culture, or even, God forbid, who have a different political outlook? Does our communion in Christ give us a real sense of unity with our brothers and sisters in Idaho Falls, in Iowa, in Ireland, or in Istanbul? Does it give us a sense of being united with our bishop, with our priest? Does our communion with Christ open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters who are hungry and suffering, no matter what religion they are? This is what is told to us on the Feast of Epiphany. Epiphany is the feast that highlights and celebrates the universality of our church in its worship of the incarnate God. Like the Magi, we want to journey to Christ from our remoteness and gather with his family in the humble circumstances of our church, even right here in humble Pocatello, Idaho, and here offer him worship and the gift of our lives, so that Jesus, our newborn King, our priest and our victim, can offer his life to us, making us one body with him and with our brothers and sisters near and far. This Christ-caused unity is the light shining forth from the Feast of Epiphany. And I pray that we all carry that light into our city streets at the end of this Mass, at the conclusion of this Mass, continuing the Paschal mystery where Christ wants to bring it. Amen.
Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father, made of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into glory, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
God's love calls all people to share in the divine life. We speak for our needs and those of every creature.
For the whole church, that all who follow Jesus will continue to lead others to the light of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace on earth, that the peace which Christ brings will become a reality for all nations, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI, who served the Church as Supreme Pontiff for 8 years, may worship God forever in the liturgy of heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are seeking meaning and purpose in their lives, that at the end of their searching, they will come to recognize Christ as the source of wisdom and light in the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our parish, that it will be a strong, united community built on love and a powerful witness to the presence of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Radiant and just God, as you guide in Magi from the east up to Bethlehem, guide us in the light of your grace and keep us always with you. We ask this through Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for the children's offering. That's you. Us and may not know, the children's collection is given to an orphanage and a homeless shelter that Father Henry Carmona sponsors. This shelter is actually in the country of Colombia, and so this offering truly expresses our Catholic universal nature, for we are helping people beyond our own front door.
Our offertory song is the First Noel, number 110.
Thank you. bread and wine just to stand on the sidewalk.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which I offer now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed and received Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nation, and when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature, and so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives your praise. For to you, Jesus Christ, by the power and Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself said, and giving you thanks, the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph blessed, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rally for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Emperor, our Bishop, the Order of Bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To all departed and brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you, either passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the goodness of your glory. Christ, O Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the same command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord.
And with your spirit,
let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. Amen. The blood of Christ. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Christ be our light, number 601. Christ be our light, number 601. God Rest You Merry Gentlemen, number 90.
Thank you.
please stand. Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and rever with true affection the misery in which you have willed us to participate. Through Christ, O Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for a couple of announcements. First is that on the Feast of Epiphany, it is the great custom of the church to mark with chalk above the main entrance a little blessing that invites the intercession of the three kings to pray for safety and healing and well-being for your home. This is a marvelous tradition. You've seen it before. You mark above your door 2000, and you put the number 20, and then you put CMB, which stands for Caspar, Melchior, and Balthazar, the three kings. Another understanding has that it's Latin for bless this home. And then finally it finishes with 2023. So this blessing, as many of you are familiar with it, takes place today. So to help you with that blessing, we have little packets of chalk that we are now about to bless. And inside the little packet is also some incense. If you wish to burn some incense in your home, you can do that. It's also just a little bit of a fundraiser. There's no price. And if you don't have money with you, don't worry. Your faith is your gift. But if you can offer something for these little sticks of chalk and this little bit of incense, it will benefit the youth of our parish. Yes, bring those out now. We're going to come down front because we don't have enough room here. So face this way. Here are our little packets of chalk and incense. Father, would you hold that for just one moment? And the blessing for the chalk is here. And this is the traditional blessing that the church provides to us.
Let's pray. O Lord God, this creator shall render it helpful to men, and that they who use it in faith and will inscribe upon the entrance of their homes the names of thy saints, Caspar, Melchior, and Balthazar, may through their merits and intercession enjoy help of body and protection of souls. Through Christ, O Lord.
Okay, now, will one of the ushers come and take this wonderfully blessed basket of blessed chalk to the back of the church now, to the entrance, to the doors? So you can pick these up on your way out. Okay. We'll just wait for a moment. There are instructions inside the packet about how to do the blessing for your home. We have one more announcement. Our school is also in the midst of their annual fundraising campaign. This one's very easy. It's called Holy Spirit 365. They ask you just to pick a date on the calendar, perhaps your birthday, your anniversary, or a special date in your life. And whatever day of the year it falls on, say it was December 31st, that would be the 365th day of the year that you offer that amount to the school. But don't worry, Father Henry already took 365 on behalf of the parish, so you don't have to worry about that one. But on the other hand, I think Jessica took January 1st for the youth group, so you don't have that one. So please, on your way out, help the school also. This is an important fundraiser for them. I chose August 15th because it's not only the Assumption of Mary, but it's Marcy's and my anniversary date as well. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God, who has called you out of darkness into his wonderful light, pour out in kindness his blessing upon you and make your hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity. Amen.
Amen.
And since in all confidence you follow Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in darkness, may God make you too a light for your brothers and sisters. Amen. So when your pilgrimage is ended, may you come to him whom the Magi sought as they followed the star with great joy, the light from light, who is Christ the Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Our sending fourth song is